Hey, kids, how would you like to hear this on the screen instead of the great show you came to see? That's what you sound like. Honest. Please cooperate and do your part in keeping this theater quiet so everyone, including you, can enjoy it. Now remember, lots of adults and kids, too, paid admission to enjoy the show. We must insist on absolute quiet. Otherwise, we will be forced to evict all disturbance makers from the theater. Those asked to leave today will be refused admission to this theater in the future. Thank you.
Are you hungry? Hungry as a gremlin? Here's Gremlin cereal.
Gremlins, gremlins, bite after bite. What a tasty way to satisfy a gremlin appetite.
Gremlins is a deliciously sweet, crunchy cereal that satisfies the hungry little gremlin that's in all of us.
Gremlins, gremlins, bite after bite. What a tasty way to satisfy a gremlin appetite.
Gremlin cereal is part of this complete breakfast.
Gremlin, yum yum.
In a hidden fortress concealed by impenetrable jungle dwells Dr. Abbott Reeves, a brilliant but devious scientist with the power to create.
Help the mandroid from the cage to call it.
Any malfunctions?
I had some trouble with this. Feels like a delay in the neurosynapse trigger.
And the will to destroy.
Move its memory and dismantle it.
It's half human.
He must be eliminated. Colonel Nora Hunter has the brains to mastermind the operation.
We need a full-time mechanic, my friend.
Fontana, the river rat.
What are you doing?
I saw this in a movie once.
When he finds himself in a tight spot, someone else has to pick up the pieces. Coochie, the ninja. He has the martial skills to destroy his enemies. The Mandroid. More machine than man. His special powers will determine whether or not they survive.
We got robots. We got cavemen. We got kung fu. What is this anyway? Some kind of damn comic book?
It is the most perilous journey any one of them has undertaken. And once they reach their destination, they face the most awesome power on Earth.
You don't understand. Soon I shall rule the world.
It will take all their combined skills to defeat him. Each one is the ultimate specialist in his field. Together, they are the Eliminators.
Thank you.
what I call good taste.
Oh! Sorry, Charlie.
Ha ha ha, suckers! You can't catch me! Nobody catches Cleveland Smith! That's right! Run, you chickens! I guess they know who they're dealing with.
Something of a sticky situation, Herr Schmidt. Give me those rubber pants and I'll help you out.
Never, you filthy, nasty pig.
I'm very dismayed to hear this information, Herr Schmidt.
Ja, kaputt!
Oh, yeah? That's what you think.
Yo!
Dear God, a towering oak.
Ella? I shouldn't have had that last arm.
Hiya, Sally. What's cooking?
Why, you are Cleveland.
Take it to the chief. He'd be more breakfast in bed.
Huh? Unhand me, you brute.
This dehydrated stuff is gonna burn.
What was I to do? I had to get out of the pot and save Sally. And then I had it. Having been a ventriloquist before becoming a bounty hunter, I
once knew a girl that was so ugly, she sent a picture to the Lonely Hearts Club. They sent it back. They said they're not that lonely. You know, she's so ugly, she needs two tickets to go to the zoo. One to get in, the other to get out. This girl was so bad, every time an ugly baby was born, she got a residual check. Now, don't you leave in a huff. Leave in a minute and a huff.
No more bad jokes. No more.
You gotta get her ready for the chief.
Oh, look. There's Big Daddy now.
Well, what has we got here?
Taste leather, sword man.
Ha 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 ha!
Cleveland, why is it that you'd come all the way into the jungles of Brazil, fight Nazis, and battle with headhunters just to get a lousy pair of rubber pants?
Well, now, hold on right there, Sally. These aren't just any old pair of rubber pants. Why, my goodness, no. These are the waiters of the Lost Park.
Wait a minute. This is a trap. Wait here.
I guess he really fell for me.
Now I've got you. Und Schweinhund Cleveland Schmidt can help her.
Und now you see why Nazis are so smart.
What? Oh, ach, liebe Braten und Milk and Cookies Dorf.
Oh, my Stetson.
Together to grab you. Phantasm. If it doesn't kill you this time, you've been dead too long. And from the creator of Halloween, John Carpenter's The Fog. Lock your windows, bolt your doors. There's something in the fog. The Fog and Phantasm. No one can escape from now. Rated R. The samurai. In his hands, slashing steel became the ultimate weapon of vengeance. And the ultimate samurai was Ogami Ito. He lived in a time of warlords and murderous clans, a time when oppressors took what they wanted, protected by the vicious mercenaries of the blade.
The governor's samurai are fast too, Ogami. It's their power you're afraid of.
Ogami stood alone against them all.
Ogami. We'll kill you if you try to leave. You cannot stand against us.
Then kill me.
He traveled a vengeance trail marked by the blood of his enemies.
Stop. Don't die for no reason. We'll leave this fight to somebody whose skill is as great as his.
A master of the blade couldn't stop him. Hired assassins couldn't touch him. And the elite palace guards fell under his sword. Valley of Hell. They threw an army at him. And he threw it back. A piece at a time. One-man war. In his hands, cold steel became lightning swords of death. Ray
raise a kung fu fist against Ogami Ito, and he'll chop it off.
On Earth in a race from sea to shining sea.
This is a death race.
You finish first or not at all. Death Race 2000. Every car a deadly weapon. Every spectator a potential point. It's a cross-country road wreck and the traffic is murder.
Who are you?
Best driver on Earth.
I don't want you to die.
He was built by the world's finest surgeons to drive the fastest car ever designed, and nothing can stop him now. Death Race 2000, rated R.
It's fun to care for Gizmo. Imagine he's your pet. It's fun to care for Gizmo and never getting wet. Make sure to keep him out of the light. And never, never feed him after midnight.
Yes, never.
It's fun to care for Gizmo. He's a lovable pet.
Okay.
What happened to Dr. Waterman? Only this man, last to see him alive, knows. Equinox. The invisible barrier between good and evil. The invisible barrier between light and the forces of darkness. The supernatural before your very eyes. As four teenage boys and girls fight a devil cult for their sanity. For their lives. For their eternal souls. Equinox, a story that defies logic, confounds belief.
Dr. Waterman, wait!
can't believe it. It was just a phone.
What is the secret of the thousand-year-old book? What are the unspeakable horrors conjured by the forces of evil? What is the fiendish power of the ring that enslaves and destroys? What is the one symbol that can hold at bay the hosts of hell unleashed on earth? Equinox, proving again that there is more in heaven and on earth than is dreamt of in our philosophy. Equinox! Equinox! Begins where Rosemary's Baby left off.
Hollywood, California, home of the magical talking picture. A mecca of entertainment, Hollywood has always been known as a land of romance and a sparkling beacon for a life of glamour. Beneath the clear blue skies of the San Fernando Valley is Universal Studios, a company whose name has always been synonymous with classic talking pictures. In addition to timeless masterpieces like these, Universal is also widely known for its thrilling theme park. Yes, these elements have all combined to make Universal Studios what it is today. But what about tomorrow? If we don't keep in step with the times, things that once were neat and thrilling can become old and stupid.
Whoa. What is going on here? Ladies and gentlemen, this never happens.
Look out! It's a shark! Here it comes! The shark is coming!
That's right. Old and stupid.
Look out! All you back there is in the back of the tram! Whoa! That is one big, scary shark! Oh, the humanity! Isn't that terrifying?
To keep up with the times, one must constantly modernize. And that's true for our studio, too. But how can we improve the studio? Well, first of all, in order for the studio to prosper in the future, we need to apply modern, futuristic ideas. The first of these ideas is being artist-friendly.
Say, what does that mean, artist-friendly?
To find the answer, let's start where most people get their first impression of our studio, the front gate.
Hello.
Oh, look, here's MCA recording star Tracy Lords. She's thinking of acting in an upcoming film here at Universal.
Your papers, please.
But the attitudes of the guards and the bleak, unattractive surroundings make Miss Lords feel uncomfortable and unwelcome.
I feel uncomfortable and unwelcome.
Of course you do. But what if our gate was more artist-friendly? We'll start with the guards. Those dark uniforms connote oppression and conformity. But new outfits, with pastel colors and high, pretty collars, seem to say, I'm your friend, not your enemy. How about some inspiring buttons to show our optimism? And what about that security gate? Black and white lines may remind artists of police and fear. But a new gate, with attractive flowers and colorful birds, becomes a lovely decoration, not just a deterrent. Now, with just a few more changes, and some attractive porcelain deer. Our gate is now artist-friendly and ready for the future. So how do you feel now, Miss Actress?
I feel welcome and relaxed from a meeting at Universal.
That's splendid. Too bad the part you want will probably go to Demi Moore.
What?
Oh, nothing. Here, have a wine cooler. Compliments of your new studio.
Thanks.
Now don't open that until you park. Now what else will make our studio artist-friendly? Well, how about that old black tower? In the past, many meetings have taken place there, but some people find it rather unappealing.
Oh, absolutely. You know, foreboding is the word that best describes it. You know, it's like real severe, you know? I mean, just a name like Black Tower, I never want to go there.
We certainly don't want to breed fear and contempt into our guests, so let's try some different colors. How about the White Tower? Or the Plaid Tower? That's right. Now let's just add a porcelain deer for decoration.
Tell Ron Meyer to be a man and say that to my face. An artist-friendly atmosphere should prevail, not only outside, but inside as well. A neat and tidy office, complemented with the proper flowers and appropriate decorative garnishes, will make artists feel at ease and thus aid in the pitching process.
That's right, Andrew Bergman. But artist-friendly is also in how we treat each other.
Wait, Mike! Mr. Lobel! You forgot your profit participation check.
Wow, $8 million.
And have some Seagram's wine coolers. On us! And here's a little pig for the kids.
Oh, thanks.
Thanks for choosing Universal.
Neat. Thank you.
Thank you, Mike.
There now, Kevin Misha. Doesn't that make you feel a lot better?
Why, yes. Yes, it does.
Yes, we can all do our part to make the studio a more beautiful, artist-friendly place.
Sweeten, enhance, beautify. Sweeten, enhance, beautify. Sweeten, enhance,
looks like James Cameron's got the idea. Say, Sean Cassidy.
Who, me?
How do you like those complimentary wine coolers?
I'm blitzed on this stuffery.
Sweeten, enhance, beautify.
Gosh, with all the wonderful improvements going on around here, everyone is going to want to work at Universal.
Yes, and that brings us to our second point. Now that we're artist-friendly, it's time to build our talent roster. You see, sometimes making things more beautiful doesn't make them better. They can still be old and stupid. So we've spent a lot of money and brought in some of the best artists the world has to offer. Like stunning actress Demi Moore.
Yes, it's true. I did just join the Universal family. Casey, Hal, Ron, they're like fathers to me. Grandfathers, even. Besides, being with the Universal family makes me feel secure, so I have more free time to do the things I love, like baking ham. Hon, ham's on!
We've also acquired director John Singleton.
And action!
Here's John on the set of his new movie, Shut Your Honky-Ass Mouth, Cracker Boy.
And cut! I am happy to be part of the new MCA Universal family, where I plan to make a lot of money.
Can I get my wine cooler now?
Certainly.
Seagram's bold and wine cooler, Seagram's.
Yes, and we've also just bought the Zucker Brothers.
We're really happy with the way we've been treated so far at Universal.
Yeah, they're so much different from all the other studios we've been at.
Yes, but we don't want you thinking about other studios. In fact, we want you to forget there even are other studios. Forget. Forget.
Forget.
Forget.
Forget.
Forget.
Forget.
Good. Good.
Forget.
That's right. Forget.
Forget.
But our new acquisitions are not only in the film world, we're also going multimedia.
Say, what does that mean, multimedia?
Well, for the answer to that question, let's go to New York City. Universal is steadily making its presence known in the Big Apple. Here at Universal Records, new bands and recording artists are signed every day. Here's the drummer from the hot new band Goldfinger. Say, young whippersnapper, how would you like to be a part of the Universal MCA Corporation?
Fuck you! Corporation bullshit, corporate whore, fuck.
Ooh, that teen angst sells a lot of records for Universal. Give that man a wine cooler.
What is this shit? Fuck you!
We also have MCA records with rap stars like Heavy D.
Golly, it sure is nifty to be a part of the Universal family. I mean, jeepers, everybody here is just swell. Golly willikers, how could I ever go anywhere else? I mean this.
And now it's on to Nashville, where we've signed some of country's hottest performers, like Marty Stewart.
I don't know how things could be any better here at Universal. They take such good care of us artists. Well, like for instance, when my album went gold, I got this beautiful deer in the mail.
But we don't stop there. Multimedia includes books, too. That's why Universal owns Putnam Berkeley, with best-selling authors like Robin Cook. Say, Robin, how does it feel to be with Universal?
I love it. It's probably the best thing that's happened to me.
Here, have you seen my newest book? Pre-written in screenplay format. Saves a lot of time. Now my book can go directly to the movies, which is a real plus, because those executives who can't read can go see the cute little talking picture.
Yes, Universal is busy making acquisitions all over the country in order to become a worldwide multimedia conglomerate of entertainment. Just ask Sylvester Stallone.
Universal sure is buying a lot of stuff.
Say, isn't that producer Barry Kemp?
But say, what about the future? We can't just keep relying on existing talent. We have to be open to new talent.
That's right, Barry Kemp. And ironically, that brings us to our final point. The last key to a modern studio is having an open-door policy.
Say, what does that mean, open-door policy?
It means anyone can share their ideas. This keeps our studio from becoming old and stupid. But where do we find new talent? You might be surprised at the answer. This is Pepe. Pepe has a great idea for a blockbuster hit movie involving two women and a lost dwarf.
I'm just a janitor. Nobody wants to hear my ideas.
Don't worry, Pepe. You work for Universal Studios, and here they welcome all ideas.
And the two women and the dwarf live happily ever after. How do you like my idea, Mr. Executive?
Write it all out, and I'm going to submit it to my development people right away, okay?
Wow, really? Thank you.
Oh, and Pepe, would you empty the trash for me, please? That's a good janitor. Thank you.
Sometimes crew members on film shoots are a source for ideas.
I've been in this business for a long time, and I've always lived by one simple philosophy. Be nice to the little people. Good morning, guys. I brought pastries.
Ooh.
Because down the road of life, you simply never know who your boss is going to be. From the lowliest PA to
Pardon me, ma'am. Do you have anything else besides jelly?
You'll eat what I give you to eat and be glad to have it. For instance, when I made clam bake with Elvis, there was...
Yes, an open-door policy allows us to find the newest, freshest ideas. Isn't that right, Mr. Stallone?
You know, it's good to be open to new talent, because that way you're more open to new talent and stuff.
So let's review our three modernizing techniques. One, being artist-friendly. Two, building that talent roster. And three, never say no to a sailor.
Say, what does that mean? Never say no to a sailor.
Yes, it's a whole new Universal here. And because of all the great changes being made here, Ron and I have decided to stay. We're both making ourselves completely available and accessible for all the studio-related functions. Ron says things are great and he's fine.
So now we're just one big happy family of movies, books, music, television, and liquor.
People, people who need people.
Yes, from all around the country, artists are starting to call Universal City Studios home. Universal City Studios, UX. And with all of our new changes, no wonder everyone is saying, it sucks for me.
It sucks for me.
And how about you, Alan Hughes?
Hey, it sucks for me, too.
Yes, and it sucks for him, and it sucks for her, and it sucks for all of us.
Gee, I had no idea Universal was making so many changes and stuff.
By constantly changing, updating, and improving, we will never fall into the trap of becoming... you know. It's the dawning of a new day. And with our new regime, we're becoming the most modern studio we can be. Thank you.
Okay, look, you're going to tell them I don't talk that way, right? I mean, this whole thing's been a gag to put on. I put the Rocky thing behind me. It's a character. You're going to work on that, right? You're going to tell them. I can...
Sure, Brainiac. Here, have a wine cooler.
Thank you very much. See, that's a character thing. It's something I work on. Fucking cheap, dude.
Hi. My name is Stephen King. I've written several motion pictures, but I want to tell you about a movie called Maximum Overdrive, which is the first one I've directed.
Wow.
What in the dickens is going on around here?
A lot of people have directed Stephen King novels and stories, And I finally decided if you want something done right, you ought to do it yourself.
And who was driving it?
I don't know.
It was my first picture as a director, and you know something? I sort of enjoyed it.
What is going on?
I don't know!
I just wanted someone to do Stephen King right.
You want a war? You got one.
I just want to get the hell out of here.
So come and spend some time with me and my friends at the Dixie Boy. Spend some time in the dark.
Please don't let us be in the dark.
Help me.
I'm going to scare the hell out of you. And that's a promise.
You're going to get us in an awful lot of trouble, man.
We already in trouble.
Maximum terror.
Jesus coming and he is.
Maximum king.
Maybe tomorrow will be our world again.
Dino De Laurentiis presents Stephen King's Maximum Overdrive.
I always do what Mother tells me, but I never could eat oatmeal until I found Oatmeal Raisin Crisp. Now this is oatmeal made my way. Crispy flakes with oatmeal, a bit of brown sugar, and loaded with raisins and almonds. Oatmeal Raisin Crisp. It's scary how good it tastes.
Oatmeal Crisp, Oatmeal Raisin Crisp.
Look, Mother, I'm eating my oatmeal.
Now that's a good boy.
Gary Busey is Buck Matthews. After 4 years in Nam and 3 years in prison, he's come home to find his family and his worst enemy waiting for him.
What in God's sakes wrong with you people? Don't you know what's going on out there? You know, it don't matter how we wish things were. It matters how we deal with how they are.
They made a big mistake, Matthews.
You know, nobody ever stood up to them before. They are going to take it personal.
Sometimes when I was in prison, I get a feeling, you know, just before something bad would happen.
You
have
it?
Yeah.
These people killed my wife, and nobody's doing a thing about it.
Do me a favor, huh? Get out of this town. Let these maggots have it.
I'm not running.
They're just playing with you, you know. Soon enough, they're gonna kill you.
I knew you'd be around here somewhere.
You got a plan?
I'm praying for vengeance.
Face to face. Fist to fist, and only one will survive.
You and me!
Gary Busey, Yaphet Kotto, Eye of the Tiger.
John Carpenter's The Fog and Phantasm. Just when you thought you were out of their grasp, they're back. The Fog has returned to prove that what you can't see won't hurt you if you kill you. And Phantasm is back to kill you all over again. Two terrorific hits together to grab you. The Fog and Phantasm, rated R.
return to the vanished kingdoms of ancient times. Journey through a lost empire of mad wizards and barbaric passions. Behold the saga of a legendary warrior, a loving father who has the power of a dozen armies in one sweep of his mystic blade. This is a story of honor, disgrace, vengeance, massacre, and a man who became a demon, Shogun Assassin. Once, he was the greatest of the magnificent samurai. Now, he hunts the evil lords who butchered his wife and stained his honor. One man and one child defy the most notorious masters of death on the planet. Like father, like son, meets the greatest team in the history of mass slaughter. Nothing on earth can match their infernal fury. Nothing on the screen can match this awesome spectacle of sword and sorcery. Shogun Assassin.
Friends. dance to your wishes in the camera lens.